Now, as an optometrist, one of the common questions that I get asked all the time is, what should I be eating to keep my eyes healthy? There's good science to suggest that the nutrition that we take in plays an important part to keeping our eyes healthy, but it's particularly important to keep the macula nice and healthy because this is responsible for the detailed vision that we rely on day to day. In this video, I'm going to give you 6 nutritional tips designed to help you keep your eyes as healthy as possible for as long as possible. Hi, I'm Martin Oguzie and this is Martin's Eye Tips. Thank you for joining me. If you're new here, please consider subscribing to the channel. We're all about helping you see better, see more comfortably and be less anxious about your eyes. And we bring you eye care tips, how-to videos and product reviews designed to help you do that. Today's video is going to be all about nutrition. So let's get started with 6 key points that you need to take into account when you start to eat for your eyes. So the first point is to make sure that you've got enough of the macular carotenoids in your diet. So there are 3 macular carotenoids, which are also referred to sometimes as the macular pigment, and they are lutein, zeaxanthin, and meso-zeaxanthin. Now, much of the time you'll hear people referring to lutein and zeaxanthin and getting these in your diet. And that's mainly because those 2 are not produced by the eye, and we have to get them 100% from our diet. Whereas it appears that meso-zeaxanthin can be made in the eye, usually made from converting lutein to meso-zeaxanthin. Now, the key benefit of having plenty of these macular carotenoids in your diet is that they help to bolster and to increase the density of the pigmentation that you have in the macular region of the back of the eye. And this healthy level of macular pigment density, as we refer to it, appears to be important in protecting you from age-related wear and tear and conditions like macular degeneration. So what types of food should you be eating to get plenty of lutein and zeaxanthin on a day-to-day basis? So as a general guide, it's predominantly plants that you can get lutein and zeaxanthin from, and the more yellow or orange in colour that they are, the better really. So lutein is found particularly in yellow peppers, mango, bilberries, and green leafy vegetables such as kale, spinach, chard, and broccoli. Zeaxanthin, on the other hand, can be found in orange, sweet potatoes, broccoli, corn, lettuce, and that's not including the iceberg lettuce, spinach, tangerines, orange, and also for non-vegetarians, you can also consider egg yolk. So my second point is to consume plenty of antioxidant vitamins. Now, the key antioxidant vitamins to consider are vitamin C and vitamin E. Now, many people are aware of the health benefits of antioxidants, but not many people know that vitamins such as vitamin C and vitamin E are a key antioxidant and have antioxidative properties as well. So what do antioxidants do? Well, antioxidants have the benefit of being able to neutralize potentially harmful reactions called oxidative reactions throughout the whole body. And this brings stability to the region and prevents a potentially harmful damage that can happen to cells and DNA, which can lead to conditions such as cancers, inflammation, you know, etc. So they do have general health benefits, but in the eye, vitamin C and vitamin E in particular are recommended for the benefit that they can bring, particularly also in combination with other nutritional elements as well. So what food should you be consuming to get plenty of vitamin C and vitamin E? Foods that are rich in vitamin C include guava, sweet red peppers, tomato juice, orange juice, sweet green peppers, strawberries, papaya, tomatoes, and lemon. Vitamin E rich foods include wheat germ oil, sunflower seeds, hazelnut and hazelnut oil, sunflower oil, avocados, and sweet red peppers. And my third point is to make sure you've got another key vitamin in your diet, vitamin A. And most people won't be aware of vitamin A by its other name, which is retinol. Retinol is an important vitamin for the health of the eye because it's used in the retina area where enzymes break retinol down and convert it to retinal. And then retinal is essential for the visual cycle in the eye. Visual cycle is basically the process where your eye converts light energy that comes into the eye, it converts it into chemical energy and then turns it into electrical energy, which it sends down to your brain for you to be able to see. And then in the visual cycle, the chemical reaction that's just occurred has to refresh itself so that it can repeat that cycle over and over again. So without the presence of a retinal, that process can't happen. So vitamin A is essential and is necessary for that process. Now, vitamin A essentially exists in two forms. First of all, we have vitamin A, which is ready to be used by our eyes and converted to retinal. And this is usually found in animal sources of vitamin A. And then the other type of vitamin A usually comes from your body converting beta carotene into vitamin A before it's able then to use it in the retina. Foods that contain beta carotene, such as carrots, can be converted to vitamin A. So they are also a source of vitamin A and can help in the visual cycle. Although it's more of a roundabout process, rather than having direct animal sources of vitamin A, which your retina can use straight away. So let's have a look at foods that are great sources of vitamin A. So foods that contain animal sources of vitamin A include cheese, eggs, oily fish, fortified low-fat spreads, milk and yogurt, and also liver. And the main sources of beta carotene from plants are the yellow, red, and green leafy vegetables such as spinach, carrots, sweet potato, and red peppers, yellow fruits such as mangoes, papaya, and also apricots. And the fourth point is to make sure you're getting your omega-3. Now, many people have heard about the benefits of omega-3, and some of those benefits extend also to the eye, and in particular, soft membranes such as the conjunctiva, but also it has benefits in helping with things like dry eyes, as well as in combination with other vitamins. It may benefit you in other ways, such as having a protective mechanism against things like macular degeneration as well. Here are the foods to consider in order to include omega-3 in your diet. So for non-vegetarians, the best sources include salmon, mackerel, sardines, and cod liver oil. So for vegans and vegetarians, then seeds tend to be your best options, and they include flaxseed, flaxseed oils, and walnuts. For number five, I'm recommending that you think about magnesium in your diet. Now, research indicates that many of us may be consuming way less magnesium than is recommended on a daily basis. And this is significant because magnesium has a wide range of benefits throughout our whole body and is important for something like about 300 odd interactions in the human body. As far as the eye is concerned, magnesium can have an impact on your muscles and muscle relaxation. So if you're somebody, for example, who experiences quite a lot of eyelid twitches in a condition that we would call meibomian or even blepharospasm, then this could be an early indication that your magnesium levels could be low. Now, you can get your magnesium from supplementation if you want to by buying them over the counter or even from Amazon. I'd recommend magnesium citrate. I'll leave a link in the description if you want to check that out. But you can, of course, get that in your diet as well. And here are some of the foods that are rich in magnesium that you can also include. Some vegetables that are rich in magnesium include spinach, potato with their skin on, okra, bran cereals, wheat germ toasted. So beans and nuts are great as well, such as black-eyed peas, soy nuts, cooked beans, tofu, almonds, cashew nuts, flax seeds, peanuts. So my final point is less about the food itself, but how we prepare it. So prepare your food right and eat fresh as much as possible. So when it comes to the food that we eat and how we prepare our food, the reality is that many of us are overcooking our food and over preparing our food way too much. So it's important to consider how we cook our food, because this has a real bearing on whether we're getting the full nutritional value of the food that we are expecting. So, you could spend a lifetime eating all this kind of great foods, but because of how the food's been cooking, you may not be getting really the benefit that you think you're getting. So when it comes to your fruit and veg, then if you have to cook it, then it's best to put the food in at the end of the cycle rather than at the beginning and leaving them all the way through. Then a good test is to just make sure that your food still maintains the crispiness of fresh food and the color hasn't deteriorated and gone out of the food as much as possible. So with fruit and veg, the color is a good indication of how much of the goodness is retained in it. So, you know, one of the best ways to cook fruit and veg, if you have to cook it, is to consider steaming it and making sure that it goes in for the proper amount of time and doesn't stay any longer than is necessary. Hopefully you found this video helpful. My question for you today is, have you found it difficult in the past to eat healthy for your eyes or eating healthy generally? Let me know in the comment section below. If you found this video helpful, then please consider subscribing to the channel. It really helps out the channel. Also hitting the notification bell as well so you get reminded when I release a new video. If you share this video as well, it really helps the channel out as well, and I would appreciate that. So until the next video, I look forward to seeing you then. Take care.